subject. One of the greatest qualities of a human being is to be able to keep quiet. It sounds very simple. To be able to keep quiet. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, if speech was silver, then silence is golden. That means to be able to know when not to say something and to control one's speech is one of the greatest qualities of human being. Sheikh Saadi has said, Takas sukhani na gufta bashad, aibo hunarash ne hufta bashad. Unless someone has not said, spoken something, you cannot know whether this man is really very learned or he is ignorant. His good qualities, bad qualities, his knowledge, his ignorance is hidden because... And then he says, Harbisha, guma mabar ke khalis, shayad ke palang khufta bashad. And when you see that there is a silent jungle, where there is no voice heard, don't think that it is an empty jungle. Somewhere there might be a lion. That means if you find a man quiet, don't try to underestimate him. Somewhere within him there might be a genius. So, to be able to control one's speech, there is one anecdote in history of Islam. Abu Hanifa is an imam of Ahlul Sunnah. He was sitting explaining the masail of Ramadan to his students, and one gentleman just entered. He was so sober, so silent, that Abu Hanifa was impressed, and not only impressed, but he in his mind started thinking that this must be a very learned man, and today if I talk, I must talk very responsibly. So he went on explaining one after the other all the masail, but at the same time under the influence of the man who had come, thinking that a very great learned man has come, doesn't say anything, don't know. When everything was over, he very politely and gently told the guest, Mr. So-and-so, would you like to tell something to my students? Thinking that this must be a great learned man. And the fellow said, well, I don't want to talk to your students, I want to ask you a question. So Abu Hanifa was really terrified that this is going to be my own test. He said, yes, you can. He said, you said that fast must be broken when the sun sets. He said, yes. Suppose a day comes when the sun does not set. When he asked that question, Abu Hanifa, rather than answering him, started beating his own chest and said, I wish I knew that I was talking in presence of a fool. All the time you impressed me that you are very learned by your silence. So sometimes silence pays, when you can be taken as a very, very clever person while you might not be. But why? Because Ali ibn Abi Talib salawatullahi salamu alayhi says, O men, do not say that which you do not know. Do not speak of that which you do not know. And then he says, and I will add, this is what Imam says, and I will add, do not speak all that you know. First is, do not speak that which you do not know. And the second is, I add, do not speak all that you know. There are things which you know, but you do not speak. And there are things which you do not know. Please do not speak about it. Because there is always a difference of four fingers. You have not seen, you are hearing. وليس البيان كالعيان. Whatever you hear is not like what you see. And therefore, sometimes people say something, they speak, it becomes allegation, it becomes tuhmat, it becomes an accusation, which of course involves guna. Therefore, do not speak unless you know, and do not speak all that you know, because sometimes it may create an impression which might be false. For this reason, one has to be very careful and discerning before he talks.